Hi, I'm John. Welcome to this Math Minute. When students fall behind in math, they often have a harder time catching up than in other subjects because of the structure of math, which requires that students progressively build upon each concept. Even in the most affluent, high-performing schools, students who fall behind by grade 4 only have a 1 in 3 chance of catching up. With learning loss caused by the pandemic, students have lost many months of learning and are facing even greater barriers in math. But there is hope. As I'll show you, with the right teaching methods, you can support learning recovery and help students quickly catch up. Students in middle school and high school often struggle with dividing by fractions. Interestingly, many adults also find this concept hard to understand. Here's an example that shows how easy it is to explain, for a student who's missed this concept, why you flip and multiply when you divide by a fraction. Imagine you have a chocolate bar with 6 pieces. How could you use the chocolate bar to show how you would divide 6 by 2? But you might decide to divide the chocolate bar into parts of size 2. So you would get 3 parts of size 2. Now if I say, show me how you would divide 6 by a half, you would need to divide each piece in the chocolate bar into 2 half-sized pieces, so you would get 12 pieces of chocolate. If you divide 6 by a third, you get 18 third-sized pieces. So you can see from the pictures why when you divide 6 by a fraction, you would multiply 6 by the denominator of the fraction. As well, I hope you can see how it's possible to catch students up, even if they've fallen far behind, with explanations that start at the right place and that use simple models to help students make sense of the math. I hope you've enjoyed this Math Minute. I'll see you next time.